Hello everyone. Today, I want to give you a quick overview of a few features that are included in the Power BI 2020 release wave 1. Key investment areas for this release are usability improvements for developers and end users, and administration improvements, including deployment pipelines, incremental refresh, data protection, promoted and certified data sets, data lineage views, and improved usage reporting. Let's start with the usability improvements for developers and end users. We are introducing a new ribbon developed with the Office Excel team. Visualization, customization, and sharing. Personalization of reports by end users. And updates to phone-optimized report creation. Well, let's see how this all works. With this release, we are again making Power BI easier to use. The goal is that someone who is familiar with PowerPoint, Excel, or any of the Office products can use Power BI to produce great data visualizations and find insights in their data. Now, one of the things that will make this possible is the new ribbon in Power BI Desktop. The new ribbon was designed with help from the Excel team, so it uses the same code as Excel. And it looks and feels the same. It's contextual as well. So when you select items on the canvas, you get contextual menus that help you find the features that apply to whatever you've selected. We also have both multi-line and single-line menus, just like in Office, so that you can have more space on your canvas. The Home tab has core options. Connecting with data, working with visuals, and calculations. The Insert tab is for adding new things to the canvas. The Modeling tab is about enriching your data, adding calculations, and also securing it and adding natural language, including Q&A. And the View tab is for working with themes, including phone layouts. For example, we have a themes gallery. And you can customize these themes, again, just like you do with Office themes. The Format tab is contextual, and it adjusts to support interactions with a specific visual. As is the Data Drill tab that provides different ways of viewing and interacting with your data. Once you use themes to edit the visualizations and then save them, you can start sharing them. Or you can go to an exterior source and bring in someone else's visualization from a file or app source. We'll search for a bar chart. Import it. And here you see it on my list of visualizations. But not in with the favorites yet. We quickly verify that this is the one we wanted and try it out. If we like it, we can pin it to the visualization pane. And there it is in the favorites. And it's now part of our default view. And we'll also unpin the original bar chart, so it's no longer in the favorites. When we open another report on the desktop or on the web, we select Edit, and the original bar chart is gone, and the new one is here. Now, if you get a report from someone else, and you have edit permissions, you may see visualizations under the dashed line. These are visuals in the report that are not part of your collection, and therefore not part of your visualization pane. For example, this attribute slicer. And like all of these items, you can review it and add it to your collection. When we move out of report offering to the end user experience, we now support the consumer of a report in personalizing the visualizations for themselves. If you prefer a different visualization than, for example, this tree map, you can now go in and select a different visualization without having to edit permissions for the report, and select the column chart that you prefer for this type of analysis. You can also change what's showing to better analyze the data. You can change what's on the axis. In this case, change from brand names to categories, to see that it was actually computers that sold about 50% more than home appliances. and then change the units to see that we're selling not 50, but 250% more computers than home appliances. Or even slice by the class of the product. Remember, you aren't changing the report, just your personalized view of it. And when you come back, you still see your changes. Or you can always reset to the default view. With this release, we've made a number of improvements in the phone layout design experience. We'll select View and then Phone Layout, which gives us our mobile canvas. And right away, you can see that we've changed the phone emulator. We've also updated the visualization pane on the right to make it easier to find and use the visuals you need. We've added the visual's name and an icon to show if they're visible or not. And we've added a gray background so that white fonts and visuals show up. We've also increased the grid resolution to allow more flexibility and tighter spacing when you add visualizations. And we've extended the length of the canvas so you can now add more visuals or overlay visuals. In the 2020 release wave 1 of Power BI, we've made administration improvements, including deployment pipelines to simplify your release of data sets, incremental refresh so you can better handle very large data sets, data protection so your data stays safe while it's being used, promoted and certified data sets so your users know which data and reports to trust, data lineage views that give you an end-to-end view from the dashboard to data source, and finally, improved usage reporting so you can keep track of how your data sets and reports are actually being used. Let's see how this all works. Deployment pipelines help you become more productive and release updates faster to your users while providing the highest quality. If you're a BI creator, you now have the option to create and use deployment pipelines. From your homepage, select Deployment Pipelines. Give it a name and a description. And we get a pipeline with three stages: development, test, and production. And we assign a workspace to the first stage, where we see a summary of what's in the workspace, and we can dive into any artifacts. The way we move through the pipeline is by deploying to the next stage. The first time we deploy, we're also creating a workspace and copying the exact states and artifacts that we have in the development stage. And you can see here that it's all the same. Let's jump to another pipeline to see what happens when the development team makes updates. Well, we can immediately see that they're different. And when we click on Compare, we see which artifacts are new and which are changed. This information helps us understand the changes and decide on the actions that we want to take. We could do a full deployment, but we'll do a selective deployment of a couple items instead. And we get a warning that we're about to overwrite several items. And now we see that the development and test stages are the same, and that the production is the one that's different. We can also set rules for each stage in this pipeline. So we can configure data connections or parameters for each stage that will not be changed in any future deployment. Sometimes you don't need to update the entire data set, and that's where incremental refresh comes in. Incremental refresh allows you to optimize your refresh because you don't need to update all of your historical data every time you do a refresh. This makes your refreshes much faster and much more reliable. You start by defining a refresh policy. In this case, it's set to refresh the last 5 years when you first invoke a refresh after publishing the dataset for the first time. And later refreshes will only refresh the last 10 days. You could also use advanced features like detect data changes to refresh only the periods that have data changes. This allows you to unlock really large datasets. For example, here's a dataset of New York taxi rides over 10 years. It's 1.8 terabytes before compression in Power BI. And it has 3 billion rows. It wouldn't be possible without incremental refresh. So to set this up in Power BI Desktop, we define the incremental refresh policy as you just saw. Then we set up some Power Query parameters to ensure that the data here is small so we can upload it easily. And we can now publish to workspaces that are either on premium or Power BI Pro capacities. Power BI artifacts are integrated with the Microsoft Information Protection Sensitivity Labels. As a result, you can apply the sensitivity label on reports, datasets, dashboards, and data flows. And you see that here. Now, when you open the report and try to export to Excel, you see the sensitivity label, and protection has been applied on the generated Excel file. So security admins can monitor sessions and prevent downloading of sensitive data to devices that are not managed by IT, like your home computer. So if you try to export to Excel from your home computer, you see that the policy blocks the download. And as an administrator, you have a report of the count of artifacts by sensitivity level and the number of incidents. And it's integrated with cloud security, so you have a single view of your data security. Data protection capabilities are now GA in Power BI Service, and also available in preview in embedded Power BI for your organization. One problem with being part of a BI team is that you end up being responsible for every data set, whether you created it or not. We now support publishing promoted and curated data sets for the entire organization, so your users know which data sets to trust and use. Let's see how this works. We start with a human resources data set. By default, only people in the workspace can access the data set. But we want to share this with the entire organization. So we go to permissions and add the user with the condition to build new content. Build permission is automatically granted when you're a contributor, a member, or an admin of a workspace. But this user is none of those, so they need to be added for this data set only. And if we go to a user's view, we see that the HR dataset is now available. We also want to assure users that this is an accurate dataset. So we go to the admin portal and we specify who is allowed to certify the dataset. Normally, you would specify a specific security group, but for this demo, we've opened it up. From the dataset, we go into settings and specify that this is a promoted dataset. So it gets a badge that says it was specifically created to be used by others. Or we could specify that it was a certified dataset that gets a badge that shows it's recommended for use by others. And we add a description explaining what the dataset is for. When we're done, this is what the end user sees: a certified dataset. Dashboards often include data from multiple datasets, reports, sources, and workspaces. And this can get confusing. With the data lineage view, you can better understand where the data is coming from and analyze the impact of any changes. Let's see this in action. From the lineage view, you can see all of the interdependencies between these Power BI artifacts. Here's the dashboard. Here are the reports it's getting data from. And if we select a single artifact, in this case a promoted data set, you can see all of the connections from the data sources up to the dashboards. And we can click on the artifact to get more data, including sensitivity, most recent refresh, number of tables, etc. Let's look at a slightly more complicated example. Say we wanted to make some changes to the data model in this data set. When we go to publish back to the service, we're not only asked if we're sure we want to override, but we also see the other artifacts that will be impacted. In this case, 11 workspaces, 15 reports, and 4 dashboards. And if we want to learn more about these, we select this link. And we go to the data lineage view where you can see all of these artifacts. And we can reach out to all of the contacts for these artifacts to discuss the impact of our proposed changes. This awareness makes it much more likely that our updates will be fairly painless. If you're going to create useful reports, you need to know how your existing reports are being used. Let's see how this works. Here's a usage report for a report. And from here, we go to usage metrics to see the new report usage format. And new to this is report performance. Here you can see how fast the report opens, the speed trends, and the browser speed comparison. We also have the report list that gives you a comparison of your report usage. And here you can see that three of the reports have never been used. And if you have questions about the visualizations, the FAQ explains what's in the new usage report. As you've seen, the 2020 Release Wave 1 update of Power BI provides you with usability improvements for developers and end users, and administration improvements including a deployment pipeline, incremental refresh, data protection, promoted and certified data sets, data lineage views, and finally, improved usage reporting. For more information, use these specific links or go to the release overview guide.